I am taking up this lecture on folding of carpet. It's a variable mass problem, interesting problem, and I have already put up a lecture on this, but there were a lot of confusion and doubts which are being raised, so I am just trying to clear doubts in this session. So just pay attention to what I am saying so that the doubts are clarified. Now here we have a carpet, and this carpet has certain length. What I am doing is, this is the one edge which I take as a reference, say 0, 0. Initially the carpet was lying like this. That was the initial position, and where the carpet edge was lying, I take that point as 0, 0. At certain point of time, I notice I am pulling it, one important point, I am pulling one of the edge of the carpet with a constant velocity v. After certain time or at any given point of time, I notice that this carpet has shifted, this means the curling part of the carpet is at a distance x from the starting point, means where the other edge of carpet was lying. Now just ignore this slight curvature. So this is the folded part, so carpet has just gone that way, means it is rising like this and coming here, so this length is effectively x. This is the length of the carpet which is now lifted. X has come here, so distance of this point from this is twice x. We have to find what is the velocity of this end, means this curling part of the carpet. If this velocity is v, what is this velocity, and what is the velocity of the center of mass of the carpet which has been folded, means say this carpet, the length which has been taken out. Suppose I have moved sufficient distance, say this distance, any distance you can calculate, this is v. So this is whole is twice x, this is x, this is x, whole is twice x. So this folded part will have center of mass somewhere, and that will be just in the middle, in the center. So what is the velocity of that center of mass? Let me calculate those velocities, and then I will clarify the doubts which are being raised in this method. If this is twice x, means this is here, up to this point is twice x, this point is a. So distance O, so this reference point is O, OA is equal to twice x. If I differentiate it, means at what velocity I am moving, if I differentiate it with respect to time, I get twice dx upon dt. This is the velocity of A with respect to O. Velocity of point A with respect to O is twice dx upon dt, which is given as v. So my dx upon dt is v upon 2. What is the velocity of this point? Say let this point be C. So velocity of C with respect to O is d upon dt OC. O I am taking opposite to this. You can take O dash or whatever. For just for the sake of simplicity, I am calling all these points which are just lying at 0, 0 on y axis are O, because this is not making any difference to the x axis. I am calling them O, you can call them different, O, O dash, whatever. So this is what? D upon dt of x. So it is dx upon dt, and dx upon dt is nothing but v upon 2. So velocity of point C is v upon 2. I'll come to the doubts part, which is very, very interesting. What is the velocity of center of mass? Now where is the center of mass? Center of mass is at a distance x upon 2 from here and x upon 2 from here. So it is at a distance of x plus x upon 2 from here. So let this be point D. So OD is equal to 3x upon 2. And what is the velocity of D? Means center of mass is D upon DT. OD is 3 upon 2 DX upon DT. And what is DX upon DT? Is V upon 2. So it is 3 upon 4. V is the velocity of center of mass. Now the confusion starts. People ask, this carpet is not stretchable. How can the two points of the carpet have different velocity? This is 3V upon 4, this is V. And their point is also correct. How can two points on the same carpet have different velocity? But here we are getting confused between the part of the carpet and point which we are taking as a reference on that carpet. To simplify, let me take first a simple example. Same situation, and there is a carpet which is not being folded. And let this length be L. Whole length be L. I am moving this with a velocity V from this end. Let me take different points. Let me take center of mass of this carpet. The center of mass, this is L upon 2 and this is L upon 2. Let this distance be x, or you can take this as x, whatever you want. Let this distance be x. So this distance will be x minus L upon 2, and this distance will be x minus L. This be A, this be D, and this be C, and this be O. So D O A upon DT is what? D upon DT of O A is x, and it is given as V. Velocity of A with respect to O is given as V. So dx upon dt is my V. One thing I've got. Now what is the velocity of D point D? D upon dt with OD is equal to D upon dt. What is OD? Is x minus, here is the catch, x minus L upon 2. So it is dx upon dt minus D upon dt L upon 2. This is a constant. So again I get V. So all points I am getting V. Why that is happening? The difference in this is, and this is, that here you are calculating the location of the points based on this distance. This distance and the length of carpet which is changing. Like when I am finding out this center of mass, I am saying twice x minus x upon 2. I did not say twice x minus L upon 2. L upon 2. Because my L, I cannot take L in this case. This L is varying. This cannot be taken as L upon 2. This is x upon 2. And I have taken twice x minus x upon 2. And here what I have taken? Minus L upon 2. Because the carpet length, this carpet which you are considering, you are finding out the motion of various reference points on that carpet. This carpet is effectively changing its length. Now, I further explain it. Now suppose, in this very case, this is a magical carpet, and by some powers, this carpet can have Aladdin ka chirag and it is expanding its length. So this point of the carpet remains here itself. Even if you move it, so it is expanding its length. So this was the length of the carpet. This you have moved V. So this is the additional length which is coming. Suppose this distance is x, which is variable. Now, every time you move that part, whatever by whatever distance you move, this length is added here. So this distance is fixed. Velocity of this end of the carpet will appear always appear as zero, but velocity of this end of the carpet will appear as v. But you will say that these points are on the same carpet, how can they have different velocity? Because the carpet has changed its length. This is what is happening. The carpet is increasing its length. And what we are trying to find out, I am not fixing the points based on a fixed reference. Had I done this, had I said at a point which is say some L1 distance. Now in this diagram, let me show you when you will get the same velocity, but then other things you will miss on. Now this is V and this is twice X. Instead of saying center of mass, I say at a distance L1 from here, at a distance L2 from here, at a distance L3 from here. L2 happens to be center of mass at this point of time. So L2 is x of x. This is x upon 2 at this instant. The instant when I have taken photo, this is L2. Now this is L2 and was my center of mass. If I write in terms of these fixed lengths, means at a distance L1 from here, L2 from here, L3 from here, what I get? This distance is how much? This is twice x minus L1, this is twice x minus L2, and this is twice x minus L3. When I differentiate, all are the constant terms and I get the same velocity. But that is the velocity of those points which are at this much distance. Now when the carpet has moved, the point which appeared to be the center of mass earlier is no more a center of mass. That is just a point on a fixed point of the carpet, but not the center mass of the carpet. If you take center of mass of the carpet, you can't say L2. You have to say twice x minus x upon 2. Until you say that, you are not saying the center of mass. You are telling about some point which is at some fixed distance from this end. Since we are not at a fixed distance from this end, because this carpet is changing its length, this end is not at a fixed distance from this end. The distance of this point C from this is not fixed. It is constantly changing based on the length of the carpet. So that is why this velocity is not same as this velocity, which otherwise is same in case of the carpet with a fixed length, because you are measuring distance based on the fixed references. That is why you get different results.